This is a wonderful illustration of how collaborative we are all being. Funding for the HDAC inhibitors program has come from FARA, from GOFAR here in Italy, from the Muscular Dystrophy Association, from the National Institutes of Health in the United States. And if you look at the work in the mice of the HDAC inhibitor, that's been supported by Ataxia UK and BabelFAMily and
we were not in a society.
It's been a widely collaborative effort around the world. There's a new drug that we haven't said much about yet because it's so new. It's from the same company, Edison Pharmaceuticals, that gave us A0001 originally. This is in the same class of molecules as the other mitochondrial agents like idebenone, CoQ10, A0001. It is already been approved for emergency treatments of very ill patients, for the most part, ones who have been released to hospice care and given 30 days to live, for example, in other indications, not in
FA. We have to stop for the second part. We start the third one now.
Okay. So the second drug I'd like to tell you about that's coming into our pipeline is called EPI-743, Edison Pharmaceutical Incorporated 743. Comes obviously from the same company that gave us A0001. It's a very promising new drug, and it's in the same category, same class of molecules as the other mitochondrial agents like CoQ10, idebenone, A0001. It has already been approved for emergency treatment of very sick patients in other indications that are related to FA, like Leber's hereditary optic neuropathy, Leigh syndrome, or SERF1 mutation. Let's take the SERF1 mutation or Leigh syndrome.
So already tested on humans.
It's being used as a treatment. On an emergency basis. Let's take, for example, there were two children with Leigh syndrome. The FDA said they are being released to their hospice care, given 30 days to live. The first little girl who was given 743 was in that category. She lived, instead of 30 days, she lived three quarters of a year, and not only lived longer, but at a considerably higher quality of life. She was initially a rag doll, and her mother had to hold her to so that she would sit up for the camera. Just a few months later, with 743 being given to her, she was holding on to her mother's fingers as she was trying to walk down the hall. So this is a phenomenal and remarkable improvement in this little girl whose smile would win your heart. She looked up into the camera trying to walk. She was just beaming. Unfortunately, she did not survive the year, but her family was very grateful that, you know, that year of her life at such an improved quality of life. And the, you know, presumption is that had she been given that drug earlier in her experience, before all that damage was done, that it may have been even more profoundly therapeutic. So that drug has been in several patients with that disease, Leigh syndrome. It's also been in a handful of patients with Leber's hereditary optic neuropathy, in which vision goes very quickly. They go from full vision to blindness in very short order. And in cases that where 743 was administered, there are a couple of cases in which vision has returned sufficiently to the patient returns to work. And so it has now been in one very ill FA patient, and the preliminary results are encouraging. There is some return after just weeks on the drug of sort of color capability and vision, much more energy. sleeping through the night without difficulties, and speech improvement that's remarkable. So we're very encouraged by this.
You said she was blind before taking
this drug. She was, before taking this drug, she was legally blind. She could not see anything.
And now she can differentiate the colors.
She can differentiate colors.
Yeah.
This is not a scientific analysis. You know, the data is not in yet, but from the parents and friends and the neurologist, they're all reporting that there's some recognition of color now, but her speech is recognizable by the speech therapist, who didn't even know she was on a drug, asked, what's going on with this little girl? Because her speech is vastly improved. Now you can have a conversation.
Is the drug going to be tested in more patients?
Yeah. The FDA has now approved it for trial in Friedreich's ataxia, Leber's hereditary neuropathy, and dominant optic atrophy. We hope to get a full-up phase 2 clinical trial going later this year. So.
Yeah, and this clinical trial, is it going to be only in the USA or also in Europe?
Initially it would probably be done just in the US,
just
the phase 2, and it would be fairly short. Sort of almost a proof of principle, proof of concept trial. If it shows promise in the phase 2 in the US, I'm sure it would be spread remarkably.
Because this drug is already in the market. I mean, if it is or not.
Oh, no. This is not a drug that's available.
In the counter.
No, this is not available anywhere.
It's not available.
This is an experimental drug, and
even for other diseases.
Oh, absolutely. No, this is experimental in all diseases.
In all of them.
This is a discovery of Edison Pharmaceutical. Right now, it's available only for Edison Pharmaceutical, and it's totally, completely an experimental drug. And it's not approved. It's approved only by the FDA for emergency treatment in those three diseases.
As a last option.
Okay.
Exactly.
Only with a very limited number of patients.
Right.
That's why
the ones that are specifically approved.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So it's been tested only in about 5 people. Six people. So, but if we get
if
the
it shows to be promising or promising?
Promising.
It would be interested to incorporate this candidate drug in the EFETS project, I think.
Oh, absolutely, and that clinical network would, I'm sure, be involved.
And is it an antioxidant or
a... It's a mitochondrial agent. We've always referred to antioxidants, but it appears that these drugs are able to do more than antioxidation.
Uh-huh.
You know, And that's great. Uh-huh. Maybe they're able to help transport electrons in along the mitochondrial membrane. Maybe they increase our energy levels and decrease oxidative stress. So I prefer to call them mitochondrial agents.
So the mechanism is not clear yet, or
it's not entirely clear yet. It seems to go beyond. We initially thought idebenone, for example, was a pure antioxidant, that it would just, you know, sop up. It would bind oxidative radicals. Well, it's just not true. It proved to be a mitochondrial agent that goes beyond that. In fact, we're trying to use these agents to strike upstream of the oxidant, prevent the damage by increasing mitochondrial energy production, by helping transport electrons so you get more energy and don't get as many radicals. So instead of sopping them up, addressing them later, we're hoping these mitochondrial agents prevent the formation of so many radicals. Mm-hmm. So.